In this Red Dead Online guide, we're gonna talk about Dead Eye system in depth, and I'm pretty sure that this video will be helpful not only for beginners but also for experienced and even high level players, because there will be many hidden facts, tests and stuff like this. Shall we begin with some basics? To activate a dead eye, you have to aim and then press a button. By default, it's a mouse wheel if you're playing with mouse and a keyboard, and right stick if you're playing with a controller. Then you will hear activation sound, screen will change its color, and here you go, you are in a dead eye mode. Now you can remove aiming, jump, switch weapons and even run. Unless you are using slow and steady, of course, because this card blocks your ability to run while in a dead eye. You will stay in a dead eye mode until you will deactivate it or of course run out of a dead eye bar that you can see here. Something important that you have to know, you cannot drink tonics while your dead eye is active. Plus your appearance on a minimap is changed, so anyone will be able to see that you are using dead eye at the moment. The effect that you gaining from activating dead eye is based on an ability card that you are using at the moment. So now let's take a closer look on each of 6 ability cards for a dead eye. They have red color. First one is called Focus Fire, and you just saw me using this ability card. It's pretty straightforward. Once you activate your dead eye, you are gaining extra damage bonus, you and all your team members, which is kinda interesting. This extra bonus is applied to your team members on any distance, they just have to be in the same session with you. But keep in mind, if other player in your party will also use focus fire, effect won't stack up, so one for party is more than enough. Next one is called A Moment to Recuperate, and it's also pretty straightforward ability card. Each time you activating your dead eye, you will start regenerating health and regenerating pretty fast. But there's one problem with this ability card. When it's active and you gonna get damage, it will stop working. Next one is called Painted Black, and this one is a tricky one. So how it works? While your dead eye is active, you can mark your targets by placing these marks on them and then just make your shots, and each shot will hit exactly to the mark that you placed. Of course, if your target is still in the line of sight. So there are a few interesting facts about this ability. First of all, marks are placed automatically. You just have to aim at your target and marks will be placed after very small delay. No need to press any buttons. Second, each shot uses a little bit of dead eye bar. Next one is extremely important. Painted black gives you perfect accuracy always when active. Doesn't matter whether you placed a mark on your target or not. Now let me explain what does it mean and why it's extremely important. Take a look at this screenshot. When you aiming at someone, you can see the dot in center of your screen and some area around it. This area shows where your bullet can hit, and whether you will hit to the radius of this area or to the center depends on an accuracy. Higher accuracy means higher chances of hitting in the center. Perfect accuracy means that you will always hit the center of this area. Of course, if we are talking about bullets or arrows, something like this. Because for shotguns, regular ammo, it doesn't work the same way. But in most cases, perfect accuracy means you will hit exactly at where you're aiming. And exactly because of this perfect accuracy effect, Painted Black is such an powerful ability card. But there is something you have to know about this perfect accuracy. It won't work against Slippery Bastard ability card, even if you are using Painted Black. Another important thing, if you are using defensive mode, you aren't able to mark people with Painted Black, as well as they are not able to mark you. But this perfect accuracy effect is still there. That's why Painted Black is such a great choice, even for defensive mode, despite the fact that it seems not to work there. Next cool fact about Painted Black, it's one of the most famous The Rolling Stones songs. Another fact, the distance from which you can mark targets with painted black is not equal to the lock-on range, and for the most cases is much bigger, for example for the bow. And speaking about the bow, when you marking someone with painted black, placing a mark and then shooting an arrow or other projectile that has some flying tine, they will follow this mark even if your targets are moving. But if at some point there will be no line of sight between the arrow and your target, the arrow won't hit. It will happen a lot if you're shooting from big distances and your opponent will just hide behind the tree or some house. Okay, enough with facts about this ability card. All you have to know is that painted black is extremely powerful and you have to know how to use it and how to deal with it. Next ability card is called slow and steady. While it's active, you are getting around 10% of damage reduction plus headshots against you are counted as a regular body shots and they just don't kill you. But you are not allowed to run or ride with acceleration while Deadeye is active. Plus, each time you are getting damage, you're losing some amount of Deadeye bar. But you can compensate this amount with the use of Kick in the Butt ability. One important thing that you have to know about slow and steady. This ability has some delay on activation, so sometime it will look like you have it active, but you will still be killed with a headshot. Next ability card is called Quiet and Inspiration, and it heals you and your party members while the die is active. The healing rate is smaller than for a moment to recuperate, but it doesn't stop working when you get in another shot. This ability card is similar to Focus Fire. It heals your party members on any distance, plus effect doesn't stack if other party member will also use this ability. Okay, this takes much longer than I've expected, but I guess we have to continue.
That's what she said.
Next ability card is called Slippery Bastard. While your Deadeye is active, people are getting low accuracy against you, but you also have low accuracy. It means you will probably mostly miss using bullets. That's important. If you are using bow or tomahawk, you'll be fine. If you are using shotguns with regular armor, still on a closer range, you will have high enough accuracy. And if you are using scopes, you will never miss at all. Two facts about Slippery Bastard. First one, it drains your Deadeye bar much faster than other Deadeye ability cards. And second, it works against NPCs just fine, so you can use it in PvE as well. Now let's make few tests that will help us to better understand how Deadeye bar and status works. So the first test, we have empty Deadeye status, it's this eye inside of the ring, and full Deadeye bar, we just drink level 1 tonic for this test. My initial thought was that status affects how fast would we use our Deadeye bar and how much we will restore each time we're restoring Deadeye somehow. Let's see, with empty Deadeye status it took 31 seconds to fully use our Deadeye bar. Now let's eat some big game meat and fortify our status. Again, drinking a tonic, and let's repeat the same test again and see whether it's gonna be any difference on using the bar. And while we are repeating this test, there is some interesting information that you have to know. There are only 3 ways to refill your Deadeye bar. It doesn't refill by itself. First one is to kill someone, second is to drink a tonic, and third one is to use some ability card that regenerates your Deadeye bar. We will talk about this later, but now let's check the result. We used our Deadeye bar in the same 31 seconds. There is no difference here, but we are using Deadeye for extra 11 seconds while we are using our Deadeye status instead of a bar. So at least there is some difference, but your status doesn't affect on a drain rate. By the way, there is one ability that helps us to have lower Deadeye drain rate. It's called the Unblinking Eye, and we gonna test it now. Meanwhile, there is one fact about Deadeye status that I found out in one of my previous tests. When you have full status, it seems like it helps you to have better and more stable aiming process. And while we are making this test, I guess it's the right moment to remind you that if you liked this video, please consider placing a like and maybe think about subscribing to this channel. There is a lot of interesting information. As you can see, it's already 31 seconds and we still have dead eye, so this ability card works. And let's take a look. It took 38.8 seconds. It means that with the unblinking eye, we are draining our dead eye bar by 25% slower. Now let's test whether dead eye status helps us to regenerate some additional dead eye when we are making kills with the help of some ability cards like Eye for an Eye and Gift of Focus. Because I've already done the test with Live for the Fight ability cards, it helps us to passively regenerate some dead eye and it worked there. But now let's make a headshot kill with two ability cards and you can see how much dead eye bar we have regenerated. Here we are getting around 10% for a kill itself, around 10% for Eye for an Eye and a headshot, and a little extra for the Gift of Focus ability card. Let's repeat this test but with a fortified dead eye status, and we are making a headshot. You can see the result on your screen. I see no difference. So it seems like for some reason dead eye status doesn't affect this ability cards, but it does affect Live for the Fight ability card. For example, because I was making the test for this ability card and it definitely restores more dead eye with fortified status. Anyway, there are four ability cards that can help you to restore some dead eye. It's Live for the Fight, just passively regenerates you some amount, kick in the butt. Each time you are getting damage, you restoring some amount of dead eye. Eye for an Eye, it restores when you kill in your opponents with the headshots. And the Gift of Focus, this ability card just improves the previous three ability cards and helps them to restore more of dead eye. All these ability cards were tested and reviewed in this channel, you can go check them, but there is some interesting fact that I want you to know. When our dead eye is active, we are not restoring any dead eye for the kill itself, but our ability cards are restoring it just fine. Please let me know in the comments what do you think about these more detailed guides on game mechanics, but I hope you enjoyed it, and as always, thank you for watching. See ya. До свидания.